Gravity is pathetic. If you've ever picked up paper clips with a magnet, you've defeated the gravitational force of the entire planet with just a tiny magnet. Why is it so pitifully weak? Even with Einstein's theory of general relativity telling us how gravity works, this is one of many things we can't explain. We need to keep investigating, and where better to test Einstein's theory than the strongest gravitational pull in the universe, inside a black hole. But there's a problem. We can't see into them because their gravity is so strong, no light can escape. Black holes can exist in pairs, locked in a gravitational orbit round each other like a dance, like in the left image. As they spiral closer together, eventually merging, the enormous energy they lose shines out into space, not as light, but as gravitational waves. The bottom left shows a typical gravitational wave signal. These tiny ripples in space-time are the lens through which we can peer into gravity's extremes. When I say tiny, I mean minuscule. Forget needle in a haystack. It's akin to finding a needle in the Milky Way galaxy. But we know what we're looking for, and by building models of the signal we expect to find and comparing them to detector data, we can find a match. Depending which model best matches the data, we can deduce how heavy the black holes are and how fast they're spinning, which gives us information about the stars they used to be. My PhD is on mergers where the individual black holes rotate in different directions to their inward spiral, shown by the blue and yellow arrows in the image on the right. Picture the black holes dancing together, but also individually pirouetting. This minor detail has a dramatic effect on the gravitational waves they produce, introducing complex extra oscillations like in the bottom right. It's important to capture these features in our models because the extra oscillations give us vital information about the gravitational behavior. But modeling them directly is impractical. I am designing a model framework which has simple inputs yet reproduces these complex spinning features. I use supercomputers to calculate my model's gravitational wave behavior and statistical techniques to see how well it fits what we expect. We haven't yet detected a real spinning gravitational wave, but my model framework could facilitate unpicking how gravity works in these extra oscillations, like why it's so ridiculously weak. I aim to, figuratively, shed light on black holes from their mergers and probe gravity's inner workings, defeating it not with a magnet, but with my computer.